I'm Ian McKinnon from the Vic High Class of 66.
And I'm Avery Mitchell from what will be the Vic High Class of 2024.
The name Wallace is almost synonymous with Victoria High School. Lawrence James Lawrie Wallace was a student who graduated in 1930 and went on to teach at Vic High before joining the provincial government and becoming Deputy Provincial Secretary. He served as Deputy Minister to three BC Premiers, two Bennetts and a Barrett. His daughter, Jillian Patricia, or Jill Wallace, was the top student in her and my graduating year, 1966. Lawrie and Jill both had a burning love for our school, long after they'd left, and their spirit has left an indelible mark on the institution and on our Vic High Alumni Association. Come Give a Cheer wasn't just a school song to Lawrie and Jill, it was a battle hymn. The Wallace Vic High legacy includes Jill's sisters, Marilyn McCurra from the class of 62, Wendy Nielsen from the class of 73, and Marilyn's son Matt from the class of 96. Lawrie was born on April 24, 1913 at William Head, and the family moved into Victoria in 1916. He began his teaching career in Alberni and moved to Duncan before joining the Royal Canadian Navy during the Second World War. Lieutenant Commander Wallace's skills were put to good use as a navigation expert serving on corvettes and submarine chasers in the North Atlantic and the Caribbean. Following the war, Lawrie obtained his Master's of Education at the University of Washington. In 1947, Lawrie joined the Vic High staff as a math teacher, counselor, and basketball coach. He spearheaded the planning and fundraising for Vic High's Memorial Stadium to recognize students who died in the war. In 1951, he founded the Vancouver Island Zone basketball tournament and was president of the BC High School Boys Basketball Association in 1953-54.
Lawrie left teaching to become Director of Community Services in the Provincial Department of Education in 1953. In 1959, he was appointed Deputy Provincial Secretary, and in 1969, Deputy Minister to the Premier, the first appointment of its kind in the province. He worked for the province until 1977. His meticulous organizational skills and penchant for punctuality served him well, as he is tasked with coordinating royal visits and also centennial events in 1958, 1966, 1967, and 1971, a role which resulted in his becoming known as Mr. Centennial. From 1977 until 1980, Lawrie was BC's Agent General for the United Kingdom and Europe. With Duncan Lorimer, he co-chaired the 1976 Centennial Committee, which celebrated Vic High's 100 years, the highlight of which was the highly successful centennial show at Victoria's Memorial Arena. He returned from London and resumed his duties as Deputy Minister to Premier Bill Bennett. He received many awards along the way, among them the Order of Canada in 1971, the Order of British Columbia in 1990, the Queen's Jubilee Award in 1971 and 2002, and honorary degrees from UBC and Royal Roads Military College. Throughout his busy life, he maintained his devotion to his family, his home, and beautiful garden. Lawrie Wallace died on January 12, 2006, just short of his 93rd birthday. He's remembered as one of the founders of our Alumni Association and as a fervent supporter of Vic High long after he'd left.
Jill Wallace was born on June 17, 1948, and her passion for Vic High matched her father's. Jill's many qualities, ascribed by her friends, included intelligence, integrity, ethical, honesty, organized, self-discipline, enthusiasm, openness, generosity of spirit, grace, and love. It was perhaps prophetic that she played the lead role of Pollyanna in a school play, perfect casting by an elementary school teacher. But Jill wasn't perfect, we're told. She failed at bird watching, perhaps because she talked too much. Jill was the top student at Vic High in 1966, and despite her small frame, was one of the Vic High girls basketball team, which competed for the provincial championship.
After Vic High, Jill attended the University of Victoria, the University of Toronto, and UBC to obtain her law degree. She finished second in her class at all three universities. Although, as kids, they lived within walking distance, it wasn't until later that Jill's sister, Marilyn McCurrick, introduced Jill to her future husband, Jack McDonald, who's sadly an Oak Bay grad. Marilyn and Jack both worked at the BC Ministry of Education, marking exams. And one day after work, Marilyn invited Jack to the Wallace family home at 1345 Fairfield Road for a Coke. Jill and Jack got married one morning in 1975 because both had too much work to do and meetings to attend that afternoon. Called to the bar in 1975, Jill began articling at Ladner Downs on the mainland, but shortly thereafter was appointed to clerk for Justice Ronald Martland of the Supreme Court of Canada. Jill and Jack stayed in Ottawa following Jill's one-year stint at the Supreme Court. She worked for the Federal Justice Department, where she was instrumental in drafting privacy and freedom of information legislation.
The couple moved back to Victoria in 1985, and Jill began working in the provincial government with the Aboriginal Affairs and Health Ministries before ending up at the Ministry of the Attorney General, where she rose to the rank of Deputy Attorney General. That marked the first time in BC history that a father and daughter had both become deputy ministers. Jill's passion there was in human rights, and she worked to get victims compensation for historical abuses at the Jericho School for the Deaf. Jill also worked on the development of the Nisga Treaty, which became law in 2000. As busy as her professional life was, like her father, Jill was passionate about her garden and always made time for her boys, Jeffrey, Andrew, and, of course, Jack. She was masterful in the kitchen too, which she found somewhat therapeutic. Her family and friends certainly benefited from her wonderful gourmet meals. In her retirement, Jill was an active member of the Vic High Alumni Association and devoted many hours to working in the Vic High archives. She died on March 1st, 2011, and fittingly, her celebration of life was held in the Lawrie J. Wallace Auditorium at Vic High.
It's with great pride that we welcome to the Vic High Black and Gold Honor Roll from the class of 1930, Lawrie Wallace,
and from the class of 1966, his daughter, Jill Wallace.